Hello guys, so today I will show you how to create a website in MVC framework, ASP.NET website in MVC framework, and I will show you how to create as soon as possible a quick way to create website and reflect data from the database, fetching database as soon as possible. So I am using Visual Studio 2015, you can use 2013, 2010, whatever you like, and for database I am using MySQL Server Management Studio, you can use 2012, I'm using 2014. So let's start from using the database. So first connecting it. So this is the server name. You might need copy it in your clipboard, you might need it later on. So connect. Yes, it's connected. So it's highlighted, so it's connected. Execute. So I have created a database company. Use it. I have created a table. I have inserted some rows and showing up the table. So this is my table, employees. So come here. Microsoft Visual Studio project. ASP.NET demo 1, our website name, MVC framework. So in this website I will show you how to create a website to fetch data from the database as soon as possible, means in very minimum steps. So as we can see that it's taking time, it's take time for the first time in creation, in initiating the process. So our website is created and these are the references. Okay, everything is done. So just go to the demo. I have to add my database, or I have to link my database to this website. And add new item, data, model 1, let it be model 1. Next, so new connection. So as I have said, you will need this server name which we got from when connecting this MySQL server here. So just paste it. Server name, refresh. Okay. So here our database was company, select. Let it be company entities, next. We have created employees table, so select it, finish. Your database should have a primary key, unless it won't be reflected here. If this comes, that means your database has linked correctly. So go to the controller, add controller, MVC5 with using entity framework, add. Employee, again adding. Our table was employee. Database context, everything is good. So we need to have controllers, views, and yeah, we need to configure root also. So So as kernel of a controller is created for employee, just go to app start, route configuration, and here change it to employees because our controller name is employees. Employees. So this is the default configuration. So it will go to the employee controller here, and it will go to the index view when we start it. Okay, Google Chrome. It's take time in the first iteration itself. Next time it won't get this much of time. Come on. So here we can see that all the data we have fetched from the database, your ID, ename, salary, manager ID, so it's all get reflected here. I can edit also. Let's change. I have reduced its salary so it's got reduced, and I can change Sam's names also. Sam 2, he won't mind. And I can create one new entry also. ID I should give 1 2 3 4 5 6, millionth, salary 6000, manager ID 2. So create. So million got added this, and we can get the details also back to list, and we can delete one row also. Means I have created million, so let's check it's get reflected in database or not. So it's get reflected in. So it's a two way. Let's delete. Yes, delete. So let's check it's got reflected. Yeah, reflected in database. So in 7 to 8 minutes we have created a website with proper functioning.